Betty White in Life with Elizabeth, featuring Del Moore. Number one in the life of Elizabeth occurred during one of her money-spending spells. Now, this doesn't happen very often, but when it does and Alvin finds out, he has to be very carefully handled. Elizabeth, how are you tonight? What have you been doing, collecting antiques again? How much did that lamp cost? Oh, pretty expensive, huh? You can shush all you want, but how are you going to keep Alvin from asking the same question? Keep his mind on other subjects? Well, he's coming in the front door right now. Better say hello.
Hi, honey.
Hi. Hey, how'd you know I was home?
Oh, a little birdie told me.
Oh?
What's in the package?
Oh, it's a little something to help us save money.
Save money?
Honey, do you mind if I sit for a while before we have dinner?
No. Why don't we go in the other room where there's more lamp? The light.
This is all right. And by the way, I had a fight with that bus driver on the way home.
Oh, I'm sorry, honey. Why don't you just lean back and relax?
Elizabeth, do you realize that they've raised the bus fares again?
Really? Well, it can't be very much, darling. I read the paper. It was just maybe a...
Not very much. They raised it a whole penny. Yes. Do you know, Elizabeth, that comes to something like 60 or 70 cents a year?
Well, now, maybe the bus company has a point, too, Alvin. You have to look at both sides of a question. Don't forget, it costs more to haul a passenger like you than it used to.
How do you figure that?
You've gained weight.
You may say crazy things, but you don't do stupid things like Charlie's wife. She went to one of those antique shops the other day, and guess what she bought?
So what did you say to the bus driver?
I really told him off. I said, look, money doesn't grow on trees, I said.
That was clever.
Guess what Charlie's wife got at the antique shop?
You're absolutely right, Alvin. You're right. Charlie shouldn't call his wife an antique.
No, I didn't say that. I was telling you, honey, how Charlie's wife made this...
Oh, offer. Now I get it. Oh, honey.
Well, I wish I did.
Oh, Alvin, really? You should write.
Really?
Now, how about dinner?
Okay. Hey, wait a minute. What did I say that was so funny?
You were talking about the play, Charlie's Antique.
Did I really? Hey, that was clever, wasn't it, huh? Yeah. Hey, what's that?
A lamp. How about some dinner?
What's it for?
To make you big and strong.
No, honey, I mean the lamp.
Oh, that's just one of those old-fashioned lamps. That reminds me, that's what we're having for dinner.
Old-fashioned lamps?
No, old-fashioned lamp chops.
Let me look at it.
No, honey, please.
Elizabeth, did you buy this?
Alvin... Did I tell you I scratched the fender a little bit on the car today?
Anybody buy a thing like this ought to have his head examined.
It isn't a very bad scratch. The car, Alvin, I scratched the fender.
Elizabeth, did you buy this?
If you want to see the scratch, the fender's in the back seat.
No, I said, did you buy this?
Sort of.
How much?
So what did the bus driver say to you?
How much?
That's a funny thing for him to say. He's supposed to tell you how much.
Elizabeth, how much did you pay for this lamp?
$17.
Do you mean to tell me that you spent $17 for this?
I didn't mean to tell you. You asked me.
Elizabeth, I slave and work like a dog all day long, and you have the nerve to squander $17 on this.
Well, I took the money out of my half of our joint savings account.
Right, let's just make the best of it now that you've bought it. How does it work?
I'm glad you're being so nice about it.
Say, you know these things used to put out a pretty bright light, honey. How does it work? What does it do?
You put the flowers in there.
Well, let's put them... The flowers?
Yeah, it's an antique. I'm gonna use it for a vase.
the next time you go to that junk shop, pick up a couple of vases. We'll make some lamps out of them.
What's in the package?
Don't change the subject.
Wouldn't you if you were in my spot?
No, I guess so.
What's in the package?
You should have seen the expression on the bus driver's face when I said money doesn't grow on trees. Everybody roared.
Just a dirty old piggy bank.
That is not just a dirty old piggy bank. That is a genuine Ming piggy bank.
Where did you get it?
Charlie's wife. You see, there was a mix-up.
Wait a minute, I'll tell you. Charlie's wife bought this at an antique shop, and Charlie didn't want it, so he palmed it off on the first sap who came along.
Well, honey, it's over 500 years old.
500 years old.
Well, it is. Look at the inscription there. Medinja Pun.
Medinja Pun?
Sure.
That says made in Japan.
Well, I didn't spend any 17 bucks. I only gave him $2.79 for it.
Wait a minute, I want to show you something. Look at this. A genuine dime store piggy bank. 29 cents. Medinja Cargo. I thought that'd make you sit up.
The fender's in the back seat of the car.
Let's get back to the piggy banks.
I shall leave you at this point, Elizabeth.
Good. And on your way out, will you turn off the stove? I think your old-fashioned lamp chops are burning. And take me with you.
You have won a hollow victory, Elizabeth.
Give my regards to Charlie. And Charlie's wife. And Charlie's horse.
Elizabeth, aren't you ashamed?
Incident number 2 in the life of Elizabeth has occurred too many times to give it an actual date. Let's just say that it happens ever so often.
Hello, Harry. Who is this? Oh, hi, Johnny. Can I talk to your daddy? Your daddy. Well, look, Johnny, I'm in a little bit of a hurry. Why not? Well, tell him to stop fighting and tell him to get on the telephone. Oh, hello, Harry. Yeah, he's a cute kid. Say, look, Harry, we won't be there for another hour yet. Elizabeth's still dressing. Well, I've been dressed for an hour, and she's still trying on nylons. Well, look, since you're having the same trouble, why don't we just meet when we get there? Right. Bye, Harry.
Alvin, aren't you ready yet?
No, I think I'll go just like I am, in my underwear.
Oh, now, honey, don't be grouchy. We're going out tonight to have a good time. I know what I'll do. I'll tell you a joke to cheer you up.
Honey, look at the time. Would you hurry up and get dressed? We don't have time. Go ahead.
No, you don't look happy. Now, here's the joke. Wait a minute. All right, I know. Tonight, I think I'll wear my baseball stockings.
That's very funny. Now, finish dressing.
No, you're supposed to ask me why I call them baseball stockings. Go on, ask me.
Why do you call them baseball stockings?
Because they have 3 runs. Yeah. I made that up.
I know.
Alvin, sometimes I think you have no sense of humor at all.
In order to have a sense of humor, you must hear a joke. Baseball stockings.
That was kind of cute.
Well, I'll tell you something, it isn't a joke. I've got on my golf socks.
What do you mean?
18 holes.
Hey, would you get me my lipstick? It's in my purse.
Isn't that pretty good, huh? You talk about jokes. Now, there is a real funny joke.
We don't have time for jokes, Alvin. We have to get dressed.
Elizabeth, I've been dressed for an hour.
You're not going to wear that jacket, surely, are you? That threadbare old thing?
What's threadbare about it?
Nothing. Nothing at all, except the cleaner said if you had it cleaned one more time, you'd have to send it back on a spool.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Look, it'll take me about 2 minutes to change jackets. Now, please hurry, will you, honey?
Wonder. No, she wouldn't. Then again, she might.
Who might what?
I was just thinking Dorothy might wear her yellow.
I
better call her.
Oh, no, you don't. Oh, no. I will do it. If you get on the phone, we'll never get there. Now, hurry and dress.
yellow shear.
Hello, Dorothy. Look, I know you're 4 years old.
I happen to know Dorothy's more than 4 years old.
Yeah, look, Johnny, would you let me talk to your mama? Look, I like ice cream. Johnny, for goodness sake, will you put your mother on the phone and let me... Oh, hello, Dorothy. Say, Dorothy, Elizabeth wants to know if you're going to wear your white cheesecloth or something. Yeah, well, look, we're in a big hurry.
Give me that phone, for goodness. Hi, Dottie. I only have a second. I just thought I'd check. Oh, good. Then you are wearing the gray.
Tell her to tell Harry I'm wearing my purple shorts.
Oh, that's Alvin. He's trying to be funny. Okay, then we'll see you in a little... Huh? Oh, no. Don't tell me she's going to be there.
Honey, a little bit...
Well, you know what that'll mean? That'll mean she'll wear that red creation. It isn't as though she can't afford to buy good clothes. You heard what she said to Ruth at the last party. No, she said, my, but you're looking décolleté tonight. And Ruth said, I never discuss politics. Oh, you know Ruth and her sense of humor. Oh, I'd have loved to have seen her face.
Goodbye.
No, there's no time for a fight. We've got to get dressed. Hurry up, Alvin.
I don't believe it.
You don't believe what?
Did you say hurry up, Alvin?
Honey, you're in my way.
Elizabeth, listen to me for a moment, will you please? Look, I'm ready to go to the party. I've been ready for some time now. You see? Let me put it another way. I went without my dinner tonight so we wouldn't be late. Am I getting through now?
Alvin, you're not going to wear that tie with that jacket, surely.
And why not?
Oh, after all, honey, a red tie. You look like your tongue's hanging out.
Well, I've got news for you. I'm so hungry my tongue is hanging out. Okay.
I get it.
Let me get it.
Let me look. Hello?
Dottie! Oh, you caught us just in time. We'd have been gone only Alvin had to change his tie.
Don't you women ever tell each other the truth?
Oh, that's too bad. Harry can't get the car started.
Tell her I'm having the same trouble with my wife.
Well, listen, I have an idea
Here,
for you.
Put this on.
Dottie? Yeah. Listen, why don't you just sit tight, and then as soon as Alvin's dressed, why, we'll come on by and pick you up. All right. That's a good idea. Honey, would you hold the phone to my ear? Hmm? Oh, yeah. Well, men are like that. Uh-huh. Ouch. Yeah? Well, Harry shouldn't get mad at you just because the car won't start. Well, after all, it's his car. Yeah, I know. Honey, will you hand me the nail polish, please?
It's so late.
Sure. What? Oh, I always have time to talk to Johnny. Here, darling.
Oh, that little monster.
Huh? Hello, honey. How are you? Oh, isn't that cute?
Yeah. Johnny's only 4 years old.
You're going to be fired if you don't hurry up and hang up the phone.
Goodbye, darling. My daddy says I have to hang up now. Bye-bye. Honey,
how in the world did this happen? Here, will you stop giggling? Oh, stick.
Alvin, what are you using for bait?
Oh, stick. Oh, this leaves too little, honey.
Well, wait a minute. I'll make my arm in here.
Yeah, do that. Here, hang it up and undo the dress again.
I can't. I'm all sticky.
Listen, we can't.
Hello? Dottie, well, the funniest thing just happened. I was just talking to you and...
Funny.
Alvin was putting my dress on. No, he was putting it on me. Yeah, and, well, I'm wearing my real dress. I'm looking at the buttons all the way up the front. Uh-huh, yeah. And, well, I know it. And it was buttoned up.
Incident number 3 in the life of Elizabeth occurred sometime last September. It seems that Alvin's boss, Mr. Fuddy, was going to put on a show for his employees on the occasion of his firm's 10th anniversary. Well, putting on a show for the faithful employees sounds like a wonderful idea. Except for just one thing. Mr. Fuddy had decided to write it himself.
Get out, idiot. Come in.
Here we are, Mr. Fuddy.
We're here. Mr. Fuddy.
Woo-hoo. Mr. Fuddy. Mr. Ah!
Oh. Oh, honey. Oh. Wait a minute.
Oh, Elvin.
Oh, honey, he's been shot. He's been murdered.
Oh, no.
Yes, he has. Honey, don't look. He's got a knife in his back. Oh, no, no.
Look, call a doctor.
Oh, wait,
now. Call a police car.
Linda, don't get it.
Do something.
Don't touch anything. Now, where's the phone? Come on, now, watch for fingerprints.
Here's the phone.
Watch for...
Oh, dear, honey.
Oh.
Hurry up.
Oh.
Honey, tell him the knife was this long.
Hello, police?
What'd they say?
Oh, I must have dialed the hospital. She said operator.
Wait a minute. Give me that phone. You're excited. Hello, emergency?
Don't talk too long. We have a lot of work to do.
Yeah. No, this isn't a toll.
Would you please?
Mr. Funny.
Huh?
What's the matter? We thought you were murdered.
Oh, Mr. Funny, I'm so glad you are.
Well, Elizabeth, honey, you wasn't even hurt. I mean, take it easy.
Oh, Mr. Funny, what happened?
Oh, I just fell down and bumped my head.
Well, does it still hurt?
Oh, no. This happens to me all the time. I have a very tender head.
Why don't you soak it in vinegar?
Now, Alvin, that isn't nice.
Oh.
Besides, that'd make him a sourpuss.
I'm quite serious. Sometimes I become unconscious just from wearing a tight hat.
Oh. Alvin, you remember that. Now, don't you ever get Mr. Funny a hat unless you make sure it's sober.
I'll tell him it's for one of my soft-headed friends.
Oh, you two don't believe me, do you?
Alvin, is this the knife you were talking about?
Who is that long?
Oh, that's a relief.
Oh, dear. Hey.
Oh, Mr. Funny, I think you have the most wonderful sense of humor.
That was funny.
Now, what about this show you wanted us to hear?
Yeah.
Well, I got a great idea about that. I've decided to open up with a little song.
There's an original idea.
Now, honey, don't be like that. Maybe it'll be good.
You want to bet?
Now, Alvin, the opening song will be sung by the fellas in the front office. That includes you.
Oh.
We're doing it to the tune of Auld Lang Syne. I wrote the words myself. Okay, let's try it.
You mind if I join in, too?
Oh, sure. That's a wonderful idea. Here, there's a copy. Are you ready? Hello, 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 hello,
hello. Aren't the words just the least little bit monotonous?
Well, not with a little dance step I figured out. Now watch, it goes like this. Hello, 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 hello. And then in the middle, you change feet. Hello, hello.
Funny, I wouldn't be caught dead doing a dance like that.
Oh,
Alvin,
the least you can do is try it.
Come on.
Let's go, Mr.
Funny. You can do it, I'm sure.
Yeah, but I'm not.
Okay, you ready? Here we go. Hello, 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 hello. Change me. Hello, 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 hello. Second chorus. Hello, hello, hello.
Mr. Funny, look, just a moment. You mean to tell me that I've got to do this stupid dance in front of all of my friends at the office?
Oh, Alvin, don't be like that. Nobody's going to recognize you.
I know, honey, but why not?
Well, it says here you'll be wearing a hula skirt.
I thought that'd be a cute touch. Can you imagine Alvin in a hula skirt?
Do you think we can find that much grass?
Are you two having a lot of fun?
Oh, now, don't be a spoil sport. Darling, this whole thing is in fun.
Oh, I knew you'd take the right attitude, Elizabeth.
Well, what other attitude is there to take?
My, aren't you noble?
You mustn't be afraid to lose your dignity once in a while.
Oh, Elizabeth, I knew you'd feel that way. That's why you're in the next scene.
Alvin's always so worried about who's in the next scene?
Wait a minute. Oh, yes, here you are. You play the part of the cockeyed mayor of Kulakakaya.
Wait a minute. I don't even work for Mr. Fuddy.
Yeah, but you pick up the paychecks.
No, you two do it. I'll sit over here.
Oh, no.
Come on.
No, you stand right over here.
Come on.
You like this, I'm sure.
Oh, really, Mr. Fuddy, I'd rather not.
I'll get the hats.
How's this, Mr. Fuddy? Is this all right? This about right here?
Oh, that's fine.
All right, Mayor.
Now, here you go.
Here's my script. I'll see this.
Alvin, we can do without your girlish giggle.
Yes, sir. Now, Elizabeth, you're the mayor, and I'm a simple Hawaiian boy. And I come up to you and I say,
Hello, Mayor of Kulakakai.
Well, read your line.
Hello, almighty warrior who swims in the lagoon in search of the devil fish so that he may feed his family of three girls and one poi. What's all this, Mr. Fuddy?
Well, they have very long names in Hawaii. Go ahead, read the rest.
What's new? Oh, there's a good one.
I have an uncle who plays guitar by ear.
That's nothing. My uncle fiddles with his whiskers. Drink, Mr. Buddy. Must I get hit on the head?
Well, that's what makes it funny.
Oh, she's right, Mr. Funny. That went out with vaudeville.
Oh, yes, but it came back in with television.
What's funny about getting hit on the head with a paper?
Well, here, I'll show you. You stand right over here. Alvin, come here.
No.
Take her script.
Oh, no, that's all right.
And you take the hat like that.
Well, really,
Now, you stand right over here, and we'll make an entrance, see? Okay, here we go.
There are several things I can count on when I have to.
What's that?
My fingers. See?
I'm sorry, Mr. Cuddy. I just don't think that's funny. Come on, Alvin, sit down. We've got to do something about this show.
You know, it's funny. He thinks all you have to do is to put on a couple of funny hats and all of a sudden you're Florence Ziegfeld.
Now, there was a clever girl.
Ziegfeld was a man.
Well, I know that, but that's the kind of jokes we need. I wonder if he heard that. Mr. Fuddy. Still clowning.
Look, he'd go to any lengths to prove his point.
Now, look. Well, this opening song is ridiculous. Hello, hello, hello. It sounds like it was written by Little Sir Echo.
Hey, how about this? Greetings, 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 greetings. Mr. Fuddy, your little joke is over now. You can get up. He's stubborn as a mule.
Let him alone. If he thinks it's funny to lie there with a bump on his head, that's up to him. How's this? Mr. Fuddy is always your buddy because he has the tenderest head.
That's good.
Huh?
Yeah.
What bump on his head?
I don't know. You said it.
Oh, Mr. Fuddy. We thought you were clowning.
Oh, I'm all right now. What did you think of the show?
Never mind about the show. We were worried about you.
Oh, that's nothing to worry about. All the Fuddies are soft-headed.
Well, I hardly hit you with the paper.
Well, I know, but I have to be careful, that's all. I had an uncle once who gave himself concussion just by flapping his ears. What do you think of the show?
Well, it was just a little bit bad.
Well, let's put it another way, Mr. Fuddy. It isn't very good.
Well, I like the way Alvin put it the best.
Well, you wanted the truth. Now, I tell you, I think we should have a completely different opening song, and we'll be glad to help.
Change it?
Why don't we have a minstrel show? We can borrow a banjo and...
We can borrow a minstrel.
Oh, wait a minute. You haven't seen the closing number yet. Oh, I'm sure you'll be crazy about it. Come on.
Alvin, I don't like your idea of a minstrel show. All
Elizabeth.
Those gloves and everything.
Just because it's my idea.
Alvin. No, not because it's your Elizabeth. Idea, honey. I mean, I just don't like the idea.
Wait a minute. Now, look, here's the way the dance step goes. Dee-doo-dee-doo-dee-doo-dee-doo-dee-doo-dee-doo-dee-doo. And then you change feet. Dee-doo-dee-doo-dee.
Mr. Fuddy, isn't that the exact same thing we did on the opening number?
Oh, yes, but I've written new words for it. Okay, everybody ready? One, two.
Hey, I'm afraid there's no time to hear the closing number. Better say goodbye to the people.
Goodbye, 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 goodbye. Goodbye, 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 goodbye.
Now here to say goodbye to you is the lovely star of our show, Betty White.
Thank you, Jack. And thank you, everybody. Thank you. You know, being together every week is getting to be a very, very nice habit. I hope you'll keep it up, will you? Until next week, once again, goodbye, everybody. Mm-hmm.